What is IP paging and how does it work? Answers to these questions and more in this video. Hi everyone, my name is Andrew with Viking Electronics, and today we are going to talk about the basics of IP paging. This video will provide an entry-level overview to the IP paging basics and the two types of IP paging used by the majority of IP phone systems. This is a good video to watch, take notes, rewatch as the world continues to embrace IP telephony more and more. If you are looking for information on Viking's IP paging line of products, there are links down in the description below to quick video overviews of our IP paging products under the label Product Shorts. The bottom line is IP paging is simply analog paging done through the internet, through a digital environment. There are two types of IP paging, like I said. The first is unicast, and then there's multicast. Let's start with unicast paging. The best way to describe unicast paging is to compare it to a traditional IP phone call, where you pick up your desk phone, you dial 123 and call your coworker. Unicast page originates from a paging source, places a call to a paging endpoint. Common examples of paging sources could be your desk phone, your class or work scheduled bell tones, or a mass notification announcer. And common examples of paging endpoints would be like an IP speaker, like a 40IP, or an IP paging amplifier, like a PAIP. And you could even have an analog terminal adapter connected to a Viking RAD-1A, the RAD-1A. And then that feeds a traditional analog paging system. Unicast paging works great for applications requiring very few endpoints or paging zones. For businesses that recently I migrated over to an IP phone system, but still have all their working analog gear in their building, still set up just the way you liked it, right? Now they don't talk, maybe. Viking's voice over IP products can be a very affordable and effective way to bridge the gap between your new IP phone system and your existing analog paging system. So I've got links below in the description that you can actually learn a little bit more about our line of products and how easy it is to set these up and make them work together. And feel free to give us a call as always for application specific questions. Unicast applications involving a lot of paging endpoints or paging zones are going to cause problems quickly. That's because each endpoint or zone requires my phone system to make an additional IP phone call. For example, if I've got 30 IP speakers in my warehouse and I want to make a page, my phone system has to make 30 simultaneous phone calls, one to each of those speakers. 30 endpoints, paging zones isn't even a big paging system. Larger systems can easily range from 50 to 100 zones or endpoint devices or more. So your CPU is gonna work really hard making that many simultaneous phone calls. You could easily lose calls, lose data, or lock up your whole CPU. Bad news. It's bad news. All of that said, unicast is still a reliable method of paging in applications using very few endpoints or paging zones, or where you have existing analog equipment that works very well, like we talked about earlier. When considering unicast paging, it's important to know the size and the scope of your paging system, as well as the capabilities of your CPU and your IP phone system. Okay, now onto multicast. Multicast paging makes a lot of sense when you think about it like a TV or radio broadcast, where a signal is sent to a transmitter and then individual TVs or radios tune in to that broadcast via the channel or a wavelength. In multicast paging applications, your audio is sent to an IP address and then endpoint devices and zones are tuned into that IP address. A key difference between unicast and multicast is the way the audio is delivered to the endpoint devices. Now let's get a quick recap of unicast. For example, if I've got 30 IP speakers in my warehouse and I want to make a page, my phone system has to make 30 simultaneous phone calls, one to each of those speakers. Multicast paging doesn't work that way. In a multicast page, my paging source makes a call to my IP address and then all my IP speakers, my 30 IP speakers, are tuned into that IP address to receive the broadcast audio. This reduces your SIP licensing fees, your hardware, and 30 isn't even the limit to how many IP endpoints and paging zones can be tuned into an IP address. There really isn't a limit. There is a downfall to multicast paging. It does require you enter one or multiple specific IP addresses during programming, and it can get very tedious, which leaves a lot of room for error. It's also technically possible for someone to gain unauthorized access to your paging system. That's not very likely. They need to know your network authorization information as well as a specific IP address you're using, but it is technically possible. Multicast is the way to page with any larger system requiring lots of IP endpoints or paging zones. It is much easier on your CPU and on your phone system. Just be sure to enter those IP addresses correctly. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video and educate yourself on IP paging. I hope you took notes and will rewatch it again and again. Please be sure to share any thoughts or questions you have down in the comments section below. We definitely appreciate that. Like the video and share it with one person you think would really benefit from learning more about IP paging. If you are not subscribed to the Viking YouTube channel yet, go ahead and click subscribe right down here so you can get all of the latest updates from Viking Electronics. Make sure you check out the description below for the links to other product shorts, including Viking's IP line of paging products. As always, please visit VikingElectronics.com or give us a call for more. I'm Andrew with Viking Electronics. I will see you next time. If an IP address is entered incorrectly, I could hear nothing. I could accidentally blast a nostalgic 90s Pandora radio station into my engineering room that only wants to hear white noise. Accidentally. Just be sure to enter those IP addresses correctly.